is the left hand. Now, I know there was one person who was playing with the right hand. Okay. I always teach left hand on top. It's not right or wrong. A lot of Native players will, let's see, a lot of hold flutes, flutes without keys, of all cultures, Chinese, whatever. You'll see players, professional players, with the right hand on top. The reason I teach left hand on top is because as a classical flutist, when you play a classical flute, it's always designed this way. Now you can have a custom-made flute if you want to play this way, but that's really, you know, they're designed to have your left hand on top. And we all, when you're little and you're a quarter, it was left hand on top because it's up to the pinky holes that are, you can't reverse it. So I like to just start people off that way so that when you get the bug and you want to keep playing the flute, it's really open to you to be able to play other flutes that are designed left hand on top. Keyed flutes, flutes with pinky holes down here, they're usually designed left hand on top. So that's why I do that. So you don't have to switch, but that's the reason I do that. Because you'll make people know, like, oh, yeah, you can play either way. But I do this because I've come from a world of, I have hundreds of flutes, and you know, it's like I can play any of them because they're all designed, you know, just like the left hand on top. But, so it might be a little confusing, I don't know. But you're next to me, so maybe it's easier to see my hands and it doesn't get you too confused. So left hand, first fingers 1, 2, 3, and then right hand 1, 2, 3, and that's it. And the bottom note of the flute, when we blow, it's the pitch A, and that's why these flutes are called A. And if you blew and it came out with an F sharp, it would be an F sharp flute, etc. A is a good key to start in, it's a nice size, most people are able to cover holes with no problem. The bottom note, A, is the hardest note to get out, so I don't start on the bottom note. It's the note that you just need to tweak it a little bit with your air pressure. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with 3 fingers down, your right hand is up. And to develop a proper right hand position, what I like to do is have all your fingers down, so that your hand, your right hand, knows where it's going to go. If you want to put your right pinky down, then you lift your right 3 fingers. Sometimes that's a good way to play as you were learning, not always playing. You don't need to keep your pinky down, but it keeps your fingers hovering over the holes, so that when you put the finger down, it knows where to go. If your pinky's not there, your finger may want to just explore and go, where is it going, where is it going, right? Because you don't necessarily want to lift your hands, it's not that easy to lift your hands. So if you want, and you're putting your first 3 fingers, your right 3 fingers down, you'll feel your thumb brace underneath your fingers, and then you put your pinky down, and that's just a sensation of where that right hand's going to go. And then you don't have to keep the pinky down, you should keep your thumb down, keeps it brace on the foot. So, left hand, let's start with our 3 fingers down. Again, it's just a natural position, not straight and not up and down, just a natural curve. And I always just let people just feel tense, you know, your fingers are a little stiff. You just let your hands shake out, relax, bring up your wrist, you get a natural curve, and that's the curve of your playing hand as much as possible. I just like to invite people to be as natural in the hand position as possible. And in terms of playing the flute now, when I was nursing, my son was now 12, so as long as I can tell the story, he gets older and older, the story is more distant. But I, as a new mother, was coming down like this to nurse, and I had incredible neck pain, so bad that I had to get someone to come help me and release it, because I was running down to him. And so then the nursing consultant said, no, bring the baby to you. You don't go bring the breast to the baby. So I believe in playing the flute. Don't go down to your flute. Bring your flute up to you. Okay? And they're super light. So if you just bring the flute up, there's no fancy embouchure. You just basically want to cover your hole. You don't want to stick the flute in your mouth, but you put your mouth in the hole and blow. So we'll drop 3 fingers and see what comes out. Play that note again. Here we go. describing keeping your left thumb in place and your right hand hovers over the holes. But right now we're just doing the higher notes of the flute. Okay? And so now lift up that first finger and then you've got just that third finger down. Here we go.
Yep. Used to.
Okay, yeah, no problem. Yeah, you can do it.
Thank you.
about it is that they do get moisture blocking the sound. So sometimes, like I think right now, we're not getting the sound. Well, it kind of sounds clogged right now because it must have unclogged it. But what you do is you take your finger and you block the hole here right below the fetish or the totem, and then you just blast it into it. Yeah, you do that kind of verbal, that's the moisture coming out. And then that frees it up, so it just sounds just...
Air just cover like half a bottle. Cover this edge so it doesn't make any noise, and then blow your foot on your finger.
You won't feel it coming out the bottom.
Yeah, it comes out here. I see here, sometimes the little
finger.
The air will come out here.
The air will come out. And face it that way, so you feel the air coming out.
Okay. All right, so...
Just put it below it.
Just blow it.
You don't turn it off.
And then push it the moisture out. So, periodically from now on, if you feel like your sound is coming out, it could be that. It could be because your fingers are leaking. Or it could be your air pressure. But if you clear it down, it should be okay for more. That's just something to keep track of as you play. It's usually about 45 minutes or so, and it doesn't really have to clear my food out. And that's something all from the state with these kids. Okay, excellent. So, I'm going to do some finger patterns, and what I want you to do is just listen and then copy me. So if you can't see me, you can adjust so that you can see me. Okay. So I'm going to do... So I want you to do the fingering that I'm doing, and if, as much as possible, if you want to listen to the tongue. Actually, I'll tongue them all right now. So just one. Remember what we talked about today. I'm just going to borrow it, just grab it from you, sorry. names of the flutes. Let me just make sure I did everything. The fetish, the south hole is what I'm calling the hole where we covered and blew our moisture out, and the fingering hole is where you put your fingers. Your flute is in the key of A, the bottom note is A. The six-hole flute versus the five-hole flute that I talked about. The reasoning is because you have a lot more notes available to you in the future. You can buy a flute with just five holes, then you're limited to just those notes. The notes of your flute are, if you don't have to have any kind of theoretical background, so this doesn't make any sense to you, don't worry about it. But when we do Western music, we use A, B, C, D, E, F, G letters, and then we start again with A. So the notes on your flute are A, all your fingers down. Now we skip B on our flute. There's not a B in terms of fingering with your holes. You can do a B by half hole. That's for later when you're more adventurous. We're going to skip to C. That gives us what's called our C, our A minor pentatonic scale.
Articulations.